sorry, I didn't see you there. Here, let me move this around a little bit. My skirt's caught. Okay. Hey guys. How you doing? Okay, let's see. Can you see me? Oh no. I guess I'm cut off slightly. I go back too far. So I just won't go back too far. Okay. This is my second cup of coffee of the day, just so you know, but I haven't smoked a cigarette yet. So I save that to smoke with you guys. I think it's like, I don't know, like 2 or 3 p.m. or something like that right now. Today is great Monday. Yesterday was my Easter, because I'm an Eastern Orthodox Christian. So we celebrated Easter. We call that Pascha, which is sort of a Greek transliteration of the Hebrew word for Passover, which is Pesach. So you'll notice that Passover and Easter, both for the Western and Eastern Christians, are all around the same time. And that is actually right around the spring equinox. For my church, it's the first full moon. It's the Sunday after the first full moon after the spring equinox. So it shifts around a little bit each year. But that being said, humans have celebrated Easter. Before it was called Easter, Ostera is another name that you might hear. But generally, human beings, as the winter went on, okay, so we have our winter celebrations. Humans have always celebrated around Christmas because you need to party around then, and it's the winter solstice. Okay, but then, as the spring equinox rolls around, we're running out of food. It's time to start planting. And everybody's essentially, whether they've been fasting for religious reasons or economic reasons, they haven't been eating much, and they've just been trying to survive over the winter. And then spring comes around, we have our Easter, we have our Pascha, and you have Passover, and you slaughter the lamb, and you feast together. You plant your crops, and you eat some meat. And that is a human tradition every spring. Since humans have been around, this is something that we do. And I'm very grateful that my church keeps these ancient human traditions alive. It's really exciting. And even though I wasn't able to attend Sunday services at my church, I was able to live stream them. And my priest did a drive-by blessing, so he organized that only a certain number of people would be in the church parking lot at a time. We all stayed in our cars, and it was really well organized. It actually went so much better than I expected it to. And splashed holy water at us from a distance, and blessed our Easter baskets. For me, I didn't have a basket this year, so I had an Easter bucket. So I had a Pascha bucket and a Pascha bag. Typically, you know, you have like a little basket filled with, you know, your eggs, your butter, your ham, your candles, typical Eastern Orthodox Easter basket stuff. But our priest is very insistent on saying, even if you don't have an Easter basket this year, please come by and just let me say hi and see your smiling face and splash some holy water on you. And even though I didn't have a basket, I did have a bucket. My mom had actually got me this really cool like silicone folding bucket that I used for some of my Easter stuff. Here is my cigarettes. I need to do my nails, but I'll worry about that later. See if we can get the light to catch on this at all. Just a little. So I'm still like in a good mood from yesterday. Yesterday was an awesome day, and I'm so excited. It's like a pretty day out today. That makes me happy. Great Monday, and it actually is a great Monday. All right. So heard me spiel about Easter, how excited I am for all of that. It's finally really spring. I have a wild idea. Okay. A little crazy. Let me know what you think. I want to show you this. This is an old copy of Roger's Thesaurus. I was talking to a friend earlier and I said Roger's Thesaurus. Roger's? But my intelligent friend knew that. let's see here. It's open to a random page. Okay, and it just flipped to the one before there. Intellect. Oh, it just, the wind just blew it past another page. Are you gonna do it again, Lynn? Yeah? Oh. Okay. It's actually still on intellect. That many pages turn, it's still on that. So, let's start with section 3, materials for reasoning. Number 467. Evidence, parentheses one side, noun, evidence, facts, premises, data, precognita, and that's in italics. I think that's probably because it's Latin. Grounds, indication, criterion. Testimony, attestation, I attest, deposition, affirmation, examination, admission, authority warrant, credential, diploma, voucher, certificate, docket, record, document, muniments, case, justificative. I don't know. What do you think? French or Latin or something? Plain English. Deed, warranty, security, signature, seal, identification, exhibit, citation, reference. Let's see here. I'm going to skip down to here. Number 471. Impossibility. Noun. Impossibility. What cannot, can never be. Sour grapes. Infeasibility. Impracticability. Hopelessness. As a verb, to be impossible. To have no chance, whatever. Attempt impossibility. Square the circle. Discover the philosopher's stone. The Orphic Egg, I'm adding that one in there. The Elixir of Life. Secret of Perpetual Motion. Wash a black amour white, skin of flint, make a silk purse out of a sow's ear. Bricks without straw, have nothing to go upon. Weave a rope of sand. Build castles in the air. Pretendere la luna avec le dent. Something about the moon. And it's definitely French. Oh, I love this next one. See if you can see that or not. Extract sunbeams from cucumbers. I just need a moment. hilarious. That's funny. Set the Thames on fire. Milk a he-goat into a sieve. Catch a weasel asleep. Romper l'anguille au genou. French, but I don't know what it means. To be in two places at once. I guess I'm in two places at once right now. I'm in this moment. And I'm also in the moment being replayed before you. I am in two places at once right now. Absolutely impossible. Yet here I am. As an adjective, impossible. Not possible, absurd, contrary to reason, unreasonable, incredible, beyond the bounds of reason. Beyond the bounds of reason, possibility. Beyond the bounds of reason, if possible, wind and weather permitting, God willing, Dio volente, D period B period. God willing. Well, I think that's enough of a thesaurus today. I'm delighted that there are some sort of inside jokes that were expounded upon as I read that random page. And again, I will say I did not choose out that page ahead of time. I opened to a random one. You saw the wind flip it around. But I liked that. That was good. I'm sorry, sunbeams from a cucumber. That's that's hilarious. Wow. Anyway. Thank you for stopping by again. I enjoyed smoking my cigarette with you. I enjoyed drinking my coffee with you. To your health, to my health. Cheers. God willing, I hope you have a wonderful day. Blessings, friend. Thanks for stopping by.